So there is an endless amount of information and supply of supplements, juices, products labeled as immune boosting. But is it even possible to boost your immunity as just like a quick fix, right? Joining us to clear up some of the common misconceptions regarding immunity is clinical nutritionist Sharon Brown. Sharon, thank you so much for joining us this morning. So give it to us. Can we boost our immune system?
Well, you can't really boost your immune system, but you can start preparing your immune system now. And now's the time to do it. It's very similar to when you are training for a marathon. You don't just get out of bed and run that marathon. You start training months in advance. And that's what we're promoting people to do. Start working on your immune system now.
So how do you do that?
Well, you do it through food. So our body was designed to be nourished, healed, and fueled through food. And so you always want to go to a food source and make sure that you're eating plenty of vegetables, clean proteins, and some fruit.
Okay, clean proteins. What are the best ones?
Proteins, things like chicken, grass-fed beef, fish.
Okay, so why is it so important now more than ever, really, to boost our immunity?
Yeah, your immune system is there to be responsive to whatever it encounters. So as we go into a flu season or any season where there is going to be any type of, you know, modified flu or a cold season, you need to build up your immune system to be able to respond, because that's what your immune system will do. Remember that 85% of your immune system is in your gut, and most people don't know that. So it all starts with supporting your gut. So when you're shopping, let's talk about, say, chicken soup. Many people think that chicken soup will cure a cold. Well, mom's chicken soup can possibly do that, but you want to stay away from the canned and boxed soups. It's quite easy to make your own chicken soup, but the key behind it is starting with a base. So I always suggest starting with a base of bone broth. You can simply find it in your frozen section at your natural store, add some sauteed vegetables to it, and then you can get a pre-cooked chicken in the deli section, and you can have mom's homemade soup within 5 to 6 minutes, and it beats that can every day. And again, it's all about supporting that immune system.
Yeah, my mom taught me how to make chicken soup. So the moment I feel sick, I make it. I don't buy it from a can. But you just brought something to my attention, bone broth. I've always heard that it's so good for you. Should we be adding that to our daily diets or weekly? Because I hear it has so many great benefits.
It has so many great benefits. And as I said, your immune system resides in your gut. The amino acids in the bone broth actually fuel the immune system that's in your gut. And so adding bone broth into your daily routine is a wonderful way to start building your immune system. And you can do it by adding it to things like rice instead of liquid. Mm-hmm. You can saute your vegetables with it. The key is finding the right one. Either make it yourself or shop for it in the frozen aisle.
Yeah, sometimes we just don't have enough time to make it ourselves, but there are easy ways to do it. Your gut, talk about probiotics.
Yeah, probiotics are great for your gut. So we have about 85% good bacteria in our body, about 15% pathogenic, and we don't need to worry about that pathogenic as long as we keep them in check. And the way to do that is to add in either a supplement like a probiotic or eat plenty of good kefir and yogurt, because those will have many different strains. In fact, kefir has almost 30 different strains of probiotics.
I love kefir, by the way, especially just like the regular one with no like vanilla or anything, just that sour taste. Okay, we got to wrap, but before we go, Sharon, can you get enough vitamin D from the sun?
You know, it's pretty difficult nowadays because most of us are wearing sunscreen. And so you want to try to get your vitamin D from food, things like eggs, milk, butter, dairy, but you can supplement, and you want to get a vitamin D that has a little bit of fat in it. So some type of oil, because vitamin D is a fat soluble vitamin, and you need the fat in order to be able to absorb the vitamin D.
Good to know, Sharon. Thank you so much for joining us and having this important conversation. I know a lot of people are stressed out these days, so it's so important to keep your immune system, in a good place.
Yeah. Thank you. Now's the time to start.
Sharon, thank you so much.
Thank you.